Hi there and welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here and in this video we are solving equations with x on both sides. Let's start as we always do with something we already know. Pause the video for me and double check you can solve for x in this case. 4x add 3 is equal to 16. Okay, I'm going to show you the answer. Double check you got the following. I got x is 13 over 4. By using inverse operations, subtracting 3 from both sides and then dividing by 4. Right, I want to show you what this video is all about. Here's the same equation as this. Now, these are the type of equations we're going to solve here. Here, there was only an x on the left-hand side. We've also solved cases where there's only an x on the right. Imagine I shoved this 16 over and I put 2x add 16 there. That is the type of thing we are going to be solving in this particular skill. When there is some amount of x's on the left-hand side of the equation and the some amount of x's on the right-hand side of the equation. But the good news is it's not hard at all. You've just got to keep using the balance method. Whatever you do to one side, remember here when we decided to take away 3 to undo that add 3, we have to do it to both sides. When we divided by 4 to undo that multiply by 4, we had to do it to both sides. Now we want x on its own on one side. So we can just do an inverse operation on both sides to get rid of, let's say, that 2x. And once we do that, that is how we're going to solve these ones. So let's actually start by doing this question here. 4x add 3 is equal to 2x add 16. I'm firstly always going to deal with the x's first. Now I want x only on the left-hand side of the equal sign. So what could I do to both sides to remove this, let's say, 2x here? What could I do to remove that 2x? Well, I could subtract 2x from both sides. And I'm going to write the subtract 2x underneath the 2x here. And I have to do it to both sides because that's the whole point of the balance method. Do a line underneath it. What would I get? Well, I'd get 4x take away 2x is simply 2x. I've still got my plus 3 here, don't forget, is equal to 2x take away 2x. Well, I purposely subtracted 2x to make that disappear. And I've got positive 16. But we don't bother writing down the positive 16. We just write 16 like that. Now we're into old territory. We know how to solve these, don't we? All we do is we're going to subtract 3 off both sides. And what are we going to get? We're going to get 2x is equal to 16, subtract 3, which is 13. And then we're going to divide both sides by 2 to undo that. Multiply 2 on the left-hand side. And I get myself that x is equal to 13 over 2. Okay? And that's the answer. If we double-check it here, 4 multiplied by 13 over 2. Well, 4 multiplied by 13 over 2. If I'm putting my 13 over 2 back in here, cancel the 2 there like that. That's going to be equal to 26. 26 add 3 is equal to 29, so I get 29 on that side. 2 multiplied by 13 over 2, well, that's 13. And 13 add 16, that is 29. So I've checked it. Okay, next question. Pause the video and have a go. Right, I wonder if you spotted the slight difference between the last question. Well, what is the difference? The difference is that on the left-hand side, I've got less x's than I have on the right-hand side. And I said I wanted the x's on the left-hand side, so maybe that causes me an issue. What I do in this case, I just rewrite the equation. I just write the most number of x's on that side and the lower number of x's on that side. I always start off like that. It's just easier. So I would rewrite this as 5x add 16 is equal to what this thing is here, 4x add 3, and I'm back to familiar territory. Now what I'm going to do is I want x on its own on the left hand side, so I need to undo that 4x. I'm going to subtract 4x from both sides. Okay, and let's see what I get when I do that. Well, 5x take away 4x on the left hand side is just going to give me 1x, and we just write x there. I've still got my add 16, don't forget. And that's going to equal, or 4x take away 4x, I've purposely picked that to get rid of this, it will be 0, and I've got plus 3. I'm just going to write 3, I'm not going to write the positive sign in front of it. And now I'm going to subtract 16 off both sides to undo that add 16, and I'm going to get myself the answer. X is therefore equal to 3 subtract 16 by the symmetry of subtraction is negative 13. And I suppose we better check before we go on. 4 multiplied by 13 is 52, so 4 multiplied by negative 13 is negative 52. Negative 52 add 3 is negative 49. Let's check it's true up here. 5 multiplied by negative 13, well, 5 multiplied by 13 is 65, so 5 multiplied by negative 13 is negative 65. And negative 65 add 16 is indeed equal to negative 49. And so I've checked it and I can be happy. Put my little smiley face there. I'm done. Right, next question. Pause the video. Have a go. Right, the most number of x's is on the left. That's good. No rewriting. Just need to take away this 3x from both sides. So I'm going to subtract 3x from both sides here and here. I'm going to get myself 3x is equal plus 10, don't forget the add 10 there, is equal to 3x take away 3x is no x's, so I'm just going to have 6 here. Then I'm going to subtract 10 off both sides to remove that add 10, and I'll get myself 3x is equal to 6 take away 10 by the symmetry of subtraction is negative 4. And lastly, I'm going to divide both sides by 3 to undo that, multiply by 3, and I'll get myself the answer that x is equal to negative 4 divided by positive 3 is overall a negative answer, and I'm going to write 4/3. Now, I could try and substitute that in, although that's going to get complicated. Let's try it anyway. 3 multiplied by 4/3 is 4, so 3 multiplied by negative 4/3 must be negative 4, and we're going to have negative 4 add 6 on that side. What about here? 6 multiplied by negative 4/3. I might have to go off and do this. 6 multiplied by negative 4/3. I'm going to think of that as 6 over 1. Cancel any common factors before I multiply. Divide by 3, get 2. Divide by 3, get 1. 2 over 1 multiplied by negative 4 over 1 is going to be negative 8. So this here is negative 8 add 10. Negative 8 add 10 is positive 2. Negative 4 add 6 is positive 2. I can put my smiley face down. I got the right answer. Next one. Pause the video. Have a go. Okay, let's deal with the x's. I want x's just on the left-hand side, so I'm going to subtract 3x from both sides. Let's write down what I get as a result of that. 6x take away 3x is 3x. Don't forget I've got my subtract 9 here. It's going to equal here negative 16. It is important you write the negative down now. When it was a positive, we didn't have to write the positive, but it's very important you write that negative. Now, what are we going to do? Well, I'm going to undo that take away 9 by adding 9 onto both sides. And what will I get? I'll get myself that 3x is equal to negative 16 add 9 is going to be negative 7. And then I'm going to undo that multiplied by 3 by dividing both sides by 3, and what will I get as my answer? I'll get x is equal to negative 7 divided by positive 3 is overall a negative answer, and we just leave it as 7/3 like that. Now let's give it a go at substituting back in to check we got it right. It's going to be tricky. This one's easier. 3 times 7/3 is 7. 3 times negative 7/3 is going to be negative 7. And we've got negative 16. And negative 7 take away 16 is going to equal negative 23 on this side. It's this side that's going to be a bit harder. If I substitute in negative 7/3 there, I have to work out 6 multiplied by negative 7/3. Better go off and do it over here. I think of that as 6 over 1. I can divide those both by 3. That would be a 2 and that would be a 1. 2 multiplied by negative 7 over 1 times 1 is going to be negative 14. So this is negative 14, and this is take away 9. Negative 14 take away 9 is negative 23. That was quite hard, but I can put my smiley face there and say, yep, got it right. And that's it for this video. Thanks for watching.